Hello everyone, in this video we are going to be talking about the parts of a circle. First, let's see how a circle looks like. Okay, so this is a circle. We are just going to label the parts and incorporate some things here. Now the first part we are going to be talking about here is the center. This point right here is called the center of the circle. Now, we can see the boundary of the circle, and it's called the circle's circumference. It's also the perimeter of the circle. That's the circumference. Now, also, a very crucial one, the most important one, is the straight line that's drawn from the center of the circle to the circumference. That's called the radius. So this line right here is called the radius of the circle. It's looking good. Another thing we are going to identify here is a straight line that's drawn through the center of the circle to touch two parts on the circumference. And that line is called a diameter. So this line is called a diameter. Now if we look at this line closely, the diameter, we are going to see that its length is going to be twice the length of the radius, because the radius is drawn from the center to the circumference, while the diameter is drawn through the center to touch two points on the circumference. Okay, this is looking good. The next thing we are going to identify is the chord. So the chord is a straight line that's drawn within the circle to touch two points on the circumference, but it doesn't pass through the center. So this line here is called the chord. It's also a straight line just like the radius and the diameter, but the difference is that it does not pass through the center. In fact, the diameter is a special chord. Any straight line that's drawn within a circle to touch two points on the circumference is called a chord. But when the chord passes through the center, the chord becomes a diameter. So a diameter is a special kind of chord. The next part we are going to consider here is an arc. So this is the boundary of the circle, what we call the circumference. Alright, so an arc is a portion on the boundary that's less than half of the circumference. So already we can see that a diameter divides a circle into two equal halves. A diameter basically does two things. One, it divides the circle internally into two equal halves, into semicircles. It also divides the circumference into two equal halves. So a portion of that circumference that's less than half of it is going to be called an arc. For example, this portion from the start of the arc to its end on the boundary is called an arc. So this portion here is called an arc. So it's a portion on the circumference, on the boundary. And of course, this was what I used. This was what I based my explanation on right here. Okay, good. This is looking so good. Now, this portion within the circle that's bounded by two radii and an arc is called a sector. So we can see it here. Here is a radius, here is another one, and the arc completes it. The portion enclosed by the two radii and the arc is called a sector. Okay, we are getting there. The next thing we are going to consider is the segments. Segments. So a segment is a portion within a circle that's bounded by an arc and a chord. Again, it's a portion within a circle that's bounded by an arc and a chord. So we can see here that this portion here, I'm going to shade it in red. So clearly, this portion right here forms a segment, because as we can see, it's bounded by a chord and an arc. So a chord does two things. It divides a circle internally and on its boundary. Internally, it divides a circle into two segments. Now the small part is going to be the minor segment. So this is the minor segment. And this very huge portion is going to be called the major segment. And it also divides a circle on its surface into minor arc and major arc. So this portion from this point to this point on the circumference is called the minor arc, while this one is called the major arc. Last thing we are going to consider here is the tangents. So this is how a tangent looks like. Here, this line is drawn outside of the circle. So what's a tangent? A tangent is a straight line that's drawn outside of a circle to touch the circle at one point only. So as we can see, this point is the point of contact of the tangent. So I'm just going to summarize all of this in words. Okay, so these are the notes. You can pause the video to go through the notes. And finally, if this is a circle and this is its center, this is a radius and this is under radius. So what we have here is called a sector, while here, this is the center of the circle. This line is called a chord. This portion here is called a segment. So because this portion is smaller than the one at the top, this is going to be called the minor segment. And this unshaded region is going to be called the major segment. While here, the shaded region is going to be called the minor sector because it's smaller, while this is going to be called the major sector. So in our next video, we're going to be solving a problem involving a sector of a circle.